Hey everyone, John Henry here, SlingshotFutures.com, and welcome to the Market Outlook, where we take a look at the market psychology of the moves today so that we can better understand tomorrow. And today, we're taking a look at the Euro-USD. Now, for you Forex traders, today was a little bit of an interesting day, right? Zooming out a little bit, as we always do, we like starting Forex trading at around 7 o'clock or, you know, a little bit after. But we still need to pay attention to what happened before that, right? That is still relevant information. We start the day off with a nice big bull channel working its way higher, and arguably this channel could be kind of cut in half a little bit with several different levels. I mean, we can see that they tried putting in a little bit of a wedge top right there. It did eventually break out, but that forms a slight area of interest. Now, generally with these little midlines, what I like to do is just put a little area, a dash dot line, fine, right? What we really want to see here is what the range of movement is, right? We broke above it, we found support. There's resistance, found resistance there, found support there, found resistance there, more resistance, broke through it, found resistance there, right? So it's an obvious level that we need to keep our eyes on. This big channel really gave us all of the clues today for the trades that really stood out. Now, we started off the day at 7 o'clock on our way towards the upside, right? Very strong momentum to the upside, and we're kind of in the middle of it. Yeah, you could buy, right? But you're sort of in the middle of the move. You're chasing it at that point. So instead, we sit on hands and wait to see what happens. The market finds its way all the way up to the top of the channel and finds immediate snap selling pressure to the downside. Now, as we always say, you don't want to be the first one to the party, but you also don't want to be too late to the party either. So waiting for the initial move to go down, we see the buyers try it again, and they fail. And that is your clue that the sellers are now attempting, at least, to take over the market. Now, it is a little bit aggressive to be selling in an otherwise bullish move, but if we zoom out a little bit further here, one thing to take note of, right? This big, thick green line. I don't know if I can zoom out far enough to actually show where that's coming from. That is a monthly high. So that monthly high area, that's a big level of interest. It's something that we really need to keep our eyes on. And if we see that the market is failing above that, it's the exact same thing that you would expect to see on any other break of a prior candle's high or low, or a swing high or low. If they go up to that area and they start failing and going the other direction, you're anticipating a counter move that is quite aggressive. The buyers tried getting above that monthly area from the prior month's high, and they start failing. And that is our clue that we need to be looking to sell to potentially drive the market back down to an area of support. Now, if you didn't want to take the initial entries at the top, because it is still aggressive, the bull trend is still intact, and it's difficult to sell in the middle of that. When you get this big follow through, that's your clue that something is wrong with the bull case, right? If the buyers are there, they're obviously not interested yet because they're wanting a better price. And if they're wanting a better price, we're probably going to migrate our way down into an area of support. And what better place of support than the bottom of the channel, which has been holding so well already? We get a push down, big drop lower, little pop, and a complete failure that allowed the sellers to drive the market down once again. The buyers tried taking it back again, and, broken record, failed once more. Now, that continued failure from the buy side tells us that, first of all, we can start selling into this move and attempt to get the market down into an area of support. And it also tells us that when we get to that level of support, we have to treat it very much like we had it up here. You don't want to be the first one to the party. You want to wait for, you know, maybe to be in the middle, right? Don't go in too late, but being the second or third one to the party doesn't necessarily hurt in this kind of case. We get some bouncing off of it, the first ones to the party, as it were. We zoom in a little bit, we can see that the buyers will have bought above that and immediately whipped out. That's why I don't like getting in too early. We see the sellers get a shot, right? Very nice looking bear candle breaking underneath an earlier area of rising support, the channel low in this case. And that is a breakout sell. Sellers may be trying to get this to continue to the downside. They completely fall apart. Right? I mean, they trigger in the sellers and then completely slam dunk them. That is a big trap, and that is a stop run waiting to happen, and we already have a bullish market on our hands. We couldn't break below the lows, and we're still struggling to get even below this area of support. So even though we are cycling off of a monthly level, remember, we're only looking at a 5-minute chart here. A monthly level only is so important when you're looking at monthly levels. So We cycle off, the sellers get trapped in, the buyers slam them right back, and we get a big bull run going back to the highs. Now, we do run into that midline once again, but we're looking for continuation. I mean, look at this strength, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bull candles back to back to back to back. After trapping the sellers, there's a good chance that the buyers are going to buy the next immediate pullback, and that is exactly what happened. We get a snap little pullback, the buyers slammed right into it and drove the market back up and attempted to get that move higher, but they ran out of steam, right? They poked their head above it, we're back at that monthly area of, well, in this case, resistance now, and what do we get? We get another turn to the downside. That starts formulating the top of a possible wedge. This could be the bottom of the wedge, could be a little bit wider, something like this. Either way, we see a continued failure off of that exact same level that this big, you know, 40, 50 pip drop came from in the first place. Sellers are obviously defending this location. As always, you don't want to be the first one of the party. You're actually buying into that one. In this case, we get a secondary attempt with a very nice looking trap on the highs and a very strong bear candle. We're now starting to show some semblance of a range, buying low, selling high, buying low, selling high. And that allows the sellers to come in and finish the job back off to the lows. And then we start moving into the lunchtime session. So just a phenomenal overview of really what happened today in the Euro-USD. Market psychology at its best in conjunction with technical analysis today give you a ton of different opportunities on the Euro-USD. So that's going to do it for this one. Hopefully you found it useful. Hopefully you learned something and maybe you can add something to your repertoire. If you have any questions, as always, you can send me an email, jbrink@slingshotfutures.com. And until the next time, we'll see y'all later.